So, when Studio first came out, I had difficulty talking to my phone. It was very frustrating. I could barely use Siri's basic functionalities, such as changing my schedule or even calling my wife. Sorry, babe, it's not me. It's the phone. When you think about it, my struggles go beyond just Siri. I learned English at the age of 17. I think Jackie Chan suffers from the exact same thing. As I said, I learned English at the age of 17. To this date, there are some words and phrases that I have difficulty saying, words that you might find simple, such as the word bill or world. In the bigger scheme of things, guys, when I hear Chinese, it sounds Chinese to me. When I hear Japanese, it sounds Chinese to me. Sometimes even German or French, they all sound Chinese to me. I wanted to see why that was, or why I sound foreign. I began to study the basics of language acquisition and fundamentals of cognitive sciences. I went to UCI and USC and talked to their professors. I even reached out to Dr. Noam Chomsky, the world-renowned linguist and philosopher. When I saw Dr. Chomsky's name in my inbox, when I saw that he is supportive of my thoughts and ideas, it felt good. One of my biggest motivations. I'm a vision scientist. My field is the eye. I had to go out of my comfort zone and learn the basics of how the speech is formed and how the mouth functions for us to talk. I studied the last 30 years of scientific work and case studies in this field. I learned that communication starts with listening, and hearing is the basis of that. I learned that exposure to pre-language sounds below the age of 6 preserves this ability for pitch and sound differentiation. And this ability is lost at the age of 6 if we're not exposed to these sounds. Again, exposure to pre-language sounds below the age of 6 maintains this ability that we're all born with for pitch and sound differentiation, layer 1 of language acquisition. And the fact that we lose this ability at the age of 6, to me, was a tragedy. I wanted to do something about this and help children all around the world that are born in China, Brazil, here, home, help them maintain this ability that they were born with. I decided to make an app. I had never made an app in my life, ever. But making an app for dummies got me started. This was a lot of work, but a lot of fun. I had to learn a whole new language here, beyond the spoken ones. Language to make an app and code with. What I did was, I compiled a database of basic units of sounds. My database has all the sounds from top languages in the world. Anywhere from Spanish, French, Italian, Chinese, Korean, Japanese, Hindi, and of course, English. Sounds such as
I, un, e, ni, e, zi,
e, ye,
and much more are in my app, and children are exposed to all these sounds through simply playing with the game. This app is a simple but very fun game. This is my main character. Not this guy. This guy here. Mochu, the penguin, who's backed up by 30 years of science, is going to travel the world and change it for our children. Mochu has lost his toys all around the world. Mochu is traveling to different continents, trying to collect his toys back, his basketball, his cars, and cupcakes, and whatnot. Through this process, Mochu is exposing our children to a family of sounds specific to each region. Behind each of those toys, there's a specific sound. With this app, I'm not trying to teach you guys a new language. So I'm not trying to teach Spanish or Chinese. This app is simply providing a means of exposing your auditory system to these fundamental units of sounds. This app will not help me with my struggle and my frustration with accent or Siri, of course. But it will definitely help children all around the world learn a foreign language and speak it with almost perfect pronunciation. Children such as Dorje from Tibet can learn a foreign language down the line in life and speak it with very good pronunciation. This app is going to be launched in November of 2013, and it's going to be available at no cost. And this app is my gift for the future. Thank you.